class, the chapter 4, crisis communication plans. Yes.
Next, foster alliances with stakeholders. Why we need to have alliances?
with the known persons. Why we need to have stakeholders? Because in this stage, in this crisis, we are facing the pwede mangyari na mawalan tayo ng resources. And develop consensus recommendations. We need to have recommendations not only on our opinions, but also the opinions of others who experienced crisis before. Kaya we need to develop consensus recommendations. Next, develop system and redundancy such as hotlines, joint information centers for GICs and websites. We need parang pasunod-sunod na information na ihahatid natin sa mga tao. Next, test messages. Yan. We need the test messages especially in initial when we are facing the crisis. Next. In planning a communication plan for the crisis that will happen, because according to this, the types of crisis that your organization is likely to encounter are somewhat predictable based on history, location, and other risk factors. Hindi tayo nangakapa. As a communicator, we have our readings, we have our evidence that the crisis that we will face in the future are already happening in the other place. Kaya hindi tayo nangangapa. We have evidences. And in these evidences, in the history, in the location, in other risk factors, we can make an effective communication plan. Pero, there's always a changes. If a typhoon strikes in Masbate, and it's a very sudden and a very super typhoon, you can never compare it to the Yolanda. There's always a changes in the intensity and longevity of this crisis or this typhoon in that place. So, dapat lagi tayo may allowance. Tsaka dapat lagi tayo, paano kung may plan A, plan B, yung communication plan na gagawin natin. And you can draft initial communication strategies and messages in blanks to be built in a crisis course. And let's imagine, syempre hindi na naman imagination. Imagination mo may evidence naman dahil sa mga history. Identify spokespersons, resources, and resource mechanisms. Paano kung nangyayari na yun ngayon? E may draft ka na. I-identify mo na lang. Ah, siguro, dahil mayroon na si Marvin sa Amono, si Marvin dapat yung magiging spokesperson nito. Kasi ano ka na, communication planner ka na lang ni Marvin. Tapos yung resources ko, dapat yung mga stakeholders, yung mayaman na ng panahon yan. Si Gabby na, si Clarissa na, sinisimula na nila ngayon. Tapos, poster alliances and partnerships to ensure that officials and experts speak with one voice and those resources are available and shared. Yan. We need to have alliances to the known persons because ito yung magbubuo sa atin, magpapatibay ng credibility natin as a communication planner. What if iba yung binigay natin sa binigay nila? Eh, mas kilala sila. Eh, kunwari, ano pa lang tayo? Ay, tayo sa ating sisidon as a communication planner. So, we need to have the partnerships. Ano ilalabas nila ng balita? Siyempre, hindi mo naman kailangan, hindi ka pwede magbase sa kanila. Kung ilalabas nila ng balita, dapat, i-check mo rin yun. Tapos, siya kasi maglalabas na balita na, or information na meron ka. Consider the document on emergency public health communication needs assessment of clarify what needs to be done. Ayan, parang sa earthquake. Sa earthquake naman, kunwari may earthquake doon ang mangyayari. Di ba nagkakaroon tayo ng earthquake drill para ma-prepare yung mga tao na pwedeng tamaan yung earthquake na mangyayari. Next, please. Ayan, may conclusion in this phase and pre-crisis community and pre-crisis is for me, treat every day as if you are in a pre-crisis stage always. So you can plan and plan. Even the catastrophe strikes, your organization is ready to control or manage the situation. So we can respond wisely, calmly, and effectively to the situation. Next, please. Next phase is initial phase. The initial phase of a crisis can be characterized by confusion because it is said during the crisis. Uncertainty and intense media interest. Diba kung sinabi nga uncertainty, walang kasiguraduhan kung tama yung information na marating sa'yo at confusion that you are facing tinitingnan nyo palang yung future, ngayon nararanasan nyo na yung crisis na yun. At communication plan nyo, just imagine that you will need to apply the plan that you made yesterday. And information issues when incomplete in the function planner. So, don't be discouraged as a communication planner. There's no perfect information in this phase. There's always a scattered information. And this is a small chance that you will get the right information. But in this phase, don't ever, ever lie to what you already know. And don't make any promises that you will never make, diba? Kasi, yan yung mga confused na yung tao eh. Kailangan nila ng assurance na may resources pa na
natin.
Kailangan nila ng assurance na may malilipatan ba kami pag bumahagi ito. Kaya kailangan natin dito ng tamang plano. Next, please. A critical part of the communicator's role is to manage the following. This is your most critical part as a communication planner is collect information about what happened. You can have information in internet, social media. Especially now, there's always false messages, and it is very critical for us to choose what is the right messages that dumarating sa atin. So, collect information about what happened. Interpret and separate the factual information from rumors. We are the communication planner, and we need to have our mayor, or we are the part of the communication planner of our mayor here in Amolo. And we need to have message the people. Kailangan nila magtanong, kailan darating yung dulo? Ilan na yung namatay sa lugar na to? So hindi natin pwedeng dahil sana may narinig lang tayong balita na may namatay dito, kailangan na natin ibalita yun. Dapat verify that information. And next, do you need the communication response? Paano ba nag-response yung mga tao sa sinasabi yung information? Na yung Amolo, magkakaroon ng super typhoon, ano bang ginagawa yung mga tao? Next, coordinate with other response groups and agencies. Next, verify the magnitude of the event as quickly as possible. Huwag tayong okay. We are facing the crisis. Oo, natural na may mag-hysterical, pero as a communication planner, you need to be calm. Dapat malalaman mo, gano'n ba katindi yung nangyayari? Para malaman ng tao. Kasi, doon nagsisimula yung mga maraming mag-hysterical. Minsan, dahil sa nagmumula sa media na mali ang nasasabi. So, next, please. Ayan. Communication objectives during this phase will require that you as a communicator. Ang ating objectives dito ay acknowledge the event with empathy. Huwag tayong puro, dahil kailangan natin ng facts, nakakalimutan natin na ang nakakaranas doon ay tao din. Namatayan sila din. Pinakamalalim na lingwahe para lang ma-inform mo sila. Hindi nila maiintindihan yun. Kailangan mo sa simple, clear terms about the risk. Ano ba yung mararanasan kapag di ka lumilap dyan? Anong delikado sa lugar na meron at pilihan mo? Establish organization is spokesperson's credibility. Yan. Kailangan mo maging constant. Kung ano yung sinabi mo nung una, ganun pa rin sasabihin mo. Dadagdagan mo, pero pag inulit mo yung dagdag mo, sasabihin mo pa rin. Para yung credibility dito sa phase na to, as a communicator, kung gusto mo i-build yung sarili mo, yung credibility mo, dito ka na magsimula kasi dito na kailangan ng tao ng tama at tapat na message. And provide emergency courses of action including how and where to get more information. Kasi kailangan nila yan. O, makakapunta kayo sa website na dito nyo malalaman. O, makakalisip kayo ng text kung baka wala na silang internet on. And coordinate messages with other organizations and agencies. O, hindi kayo nag-iisa. United kayo sa community dapat. Kaya dapat may coordination kayo sa mga organizations by agencies na nandun sa community na nyo. And communities with stakeholders and the public to continue communication and remain accessible. Next, please. In the initial phase of a crisis or emergency, the public wants information about the situation immediately, including who, what, where, when, and why. Para sinasabi ni ma'am, tell the numbers right, explain the numbers. Para sinasabi ng kailangan na yung who, what, when, and why. Provide timely and accurate facts, including where the crisis occurred. Diba? Saan nagsimula? Kunyari may sunog, saan nagsimula yung sunog? And say what is plan na ginagawa na ba si Mayor? May ginagawa na ba yung kapulisan ng Angolo? Give credible answers regarding the magnitude of the crisis, including possible threats to the public. And share the possible duration of the crisis. And explain as much as you can who will fix the problem and when. Hindi yung dito kayo mga ngako na, ay, ayusin namin yung problema niyan sa madusap. Napakadaling panahon. Pero hindi nyo naman magagawa. Ang kailangan ng tao dito na sa lantasin, ang kailangan nila totoo, dapat-tapat. Kasi bumubuhin kayo ng credibility nyo dito. Next, please.
Tulog yung mga kagulpo ko. Hindi ko, ganito pala ito kakagrabe.
Maintenance space. Una, pinag-arap, pangatlo na ito sa phase na ano. The maintenance space generally begins when most or all of the direct harm is contained. Natasin na lahat ng direct harm. Binagyo na kayo, sira na bahay nyo, wala na kayong matulugan. Most or all of the direct harm is contained and the intensity of the crisis begins to subside. Wala na, wala nang bagyo, pero sila naman bahay nyo. Wala nang bagyo, lalas ako sa mas bati yan. Wala nang bagyo, sila naman bahay namin. Ayan. Begins to subside. Sinasabi ng mga communicator planner, mga communication planner na alam nyo na maintenance space na pag pwede na kayong maligo, pag kaya nyo ng maligo. Kasi alam nyo yun, na sobrang busy nila, hindi na nila magawa ang maligo. So, next please. Communication objectives during this phase include the following. Help the public more accurately understand its goal. This provide background and encompassing information to those who need it. Or to answer questions such as this. How could this happen? Had this happened before? How can we keep this from happening again? Will I be alright in the long term if I recover? Dito nila sasabihin na nangyari na to dati. We have history, we have the facts that na nangyari na to dati. But, dahil sa nangyari na to dati, lagi nyo, dapat paano nyo rin, explain nyo rin na nalagpasan rito ng maayos at tulad ng mangyayari sa ngayon. Pero wag okay, kasi mag-expect yung tao. And generate understanding and support for response and recovery plans. Listen to stakeholder and audience feedback and correct misinformation. Explain emergency recommendations and empower risk and benefit decision making. Next, please. Sige pa. Ayan, this is resolution phase. The maintenance phase and the resolution phase often blend into one another as the crisis continues to wind down. It is important to acknowledge the resolution phase may take considerable time as details of the event and the special responsibility and blame are addressed. Expect na marami ng sisi na darating. Dahil i-evaluate kung ilang ginawa nyo. Ang parang ginawa ng mga communication planner, ba't naging ganito yun? Marami na at yung mga hindi pa involved na tao, sa kanila pa kayo makakarinig ng criticism. Next please. And some objectives for this phase include implement plans, improve appropriate public response for future similar emergencies through education, understand examine problems and mishaps, and then reinforce what works and address what didn't work in the recovery and response effort, persuade the public to support public policy, and resource allocation to the problem, promote activities and capabilities of the organization, help reinforce the identity of your organization as capable and responsive. In this phase, ilalatag nyo na dito. Ilalatag nyo na naging plano nyo. Yung pre-crisis, di ba? You have planned on pre-crisis and dito ilalatag nyo na. Pag ilalatag nyo na, ipakita nyo kung ano yung naging tama na sa lahat ng plano nyo. Kung sinasabi na. Ipakita nyo kung ano yung naging tama, naging effective sa lahat ng naging plano nyo. Ipakita nyo kung yung naging hindi. At pagdating sa evaluation plan, i-evaluate, mapaplano ulit kayo kung ano mas ganda at magandang gawin pag susunod na nagkaroon ulit ng crisis na ganito. Ganun lang yun na. Sige na, Ben. Paano na? Next lang. When the crisis is over, nandito na tayo sa evaluation. Evaluate responses including communication effectiveness. Gano'n ba kayo naging ka-epektibo? Document and communicate lessons learned. What worked and where were the challenges? Ano nga ba yung naging effective doon sa mga naging plano nyo? Dapat sa mga naging basta pangyayari, dapat may matutunan pa rin kayo. As a communication planner, you will always learn from the things that
kailangan ko na
may pinag-work. After nun, guys.
Uy, ano?
Mapabilisin ko lang talaga yung ano.
Kay Marimar.
Pinaplano nyo na yung mga gagawin ninyo. Kaya importante yung ano, yung assist at the table for communication kasi ito yung mga kailan niya. Communication has been recognized as a core emergency response function by the Department of Health and Human Service and the Department of Homeland Security. Next, the mildly cases of failed or ineffective communication have made crisis much worse. Example nito yung hurricane yung sa ano sa Katrina in 2005 tsaka yung katang sa September 11 2001 talaga yun.
2017
an effective response that requires communication even the best well informed and creative decision. Operation benefits to an investment in public information activities. Yon, kailangan kailangan alam din nila yung mga mangyayari or nangyari dun sa mga plans. Meron kasi kung hindi na sa akin yan, so speed ko na din. Yung example niya, yung tsunami na nangyari sa Japan, yung tsunami na nangyari sa Japan, na hindi sila handa kasi mali, kulang yung information na nasabi nila. So, pagkatapos ng tsunami yun, nakalagay dito sa Mystic Handles na pagkatapos nung nangyari yun, sila naghanda na sila, bawat school, bawat estudyante, tinuturoan nila kung ano yung pwedeng mangyari. Tapos, di ba, sa Japan ngayon, dun mo na makikita yung ano, magandang cellphone, magandang, basta ginagamit sa pag-communicate sa kanila na yung, sa kanila na yung maganda.
Maganda na lang.
Kanila yung effective kasi dun sa naranasan nila, ginagamit nila yun para maging maayos yung lang nila.
Sila na yung maganda.
Walang next chance. When communication professionals are seated at the decision-making table, they can provide the following. When communication professionals have customer and audience focus, organizational focus, kasi kagaya nga ng sinabi namin kanina, hindi lang dapat sa organization nyo na hindi lang yung planning, hindi lang dapat sa organization nyo, para din dun sa mga tao nakapaligo sa inyo. Sa customer and audience focus, kailangan represent the perspective or diverse audience and stakeholders, empower local decision making, provide feedback to respondents, represent fair and responsible. Represent fair and responsible sources allocation, advocate for a return to well-being and normality. Next, organizational focus, coordinate and facilitate response and recovery reports, build consensus and consistency of message, generate support for crisis management plans and activities, clarify communication obligation and process, avoid misallocation of limited sources, acquire and present critical information and facts, reduce and respond to rumors, process understanding and longer term thinking, kasama din yon, represent the competing demands and interest in decision, provide consideration of longer term implication and needs, avoid statement and decision that limit your flexibility. Yon, kailangan pag nagpa-plano kayo, hindi kailangan na mabali-bali ninyo, hindi lang nakapokus kayo sa iba, kailangan isa-isa, kailangan pwede yung plano ninyo, pwede dito, pwede doon, pwede sa kahit saan. Understand the need for multiple partners and perspective in the response. The role of communication with Emergency Operation Center or EOC, planners and leaders should be explored and discuss advanced events such as Hurricane Katrina, kagaya nga yung sabi kanina, and the Red River floods in North Dakota, yung mga example nun, provide powerful example yun. Kailangan yung dun sa mga gagawin natin, ano, alam na natin, makukuha tayo kahit hindi yung sa Pilipinas nangyari, na kahit sa ibang bansa, may proof tayo na kailangan ganito yung gawin natin para hindi na mangyari yung nangyari sa iba. Yun. Thank you. Ang next reporter po ay si Mae Larcena.
So good afternoon, everyone. So as we discussed about crisis communication plan, sabi ni Ruth kanina, yung mga bagay na tumutukoy sa crisis communication, and then we will go through on how to develop a good communication plan. So in every crisis, it needs to have a communication plan. So next. So what is plan? Any one of you can read the first sentence. Yes, Ronji.
A plan is to be
Michael, di ba trabaho mo yun?
So sabi dito, implant is likely any diagram or lesion step with timing and resources used to achieve an objective. So sabi yan yung Wikipedia. So it is a diagram that needs to be followed by men. So a step that the public will follow. So step of procedure or procedure siya na kung saan it will serve as a guideline for the community para doon na sila mag-focus, which is yung objective masunod. So, sabi ng business dictionary.com, it is a written account of intended future courses of action in achieving specific or objective within a specific time of frame, and it explains in detail what needs to be done, when, how, and by whom, and often includes best case, expected case, and worst case scenarios. So, sino ba yung gumagawa ng communication plan? Siyempre, yung mga communication expert or yung mga planners na related sa crisis na tumutukoy. There is a lot of crisis na nangyayari sa atin. So, example, we have a catastrophe in terms of typhoon. So, sino yung maaari natin gamitin yung communication researcher doon? So, yes, tama ka, Olga. Ang example dyan, so, in terms of the typhoon, ang ikakontak natin ay yung mga communication expert na related sa typhoon. Example, ang pag-asa. Or maybe the military to help the public to evacuate. Or maybe the DOH to provide medicine for other aid para maagapan ni yung pangalan. So next. So for other definition, Dixie, pakibasa ka yung first communication plan example na definition. So sabi, ang crisis communication plan nung maaari maging mangyari. Parang ito yung summary of what will be happen. So next, crisis communication plan is the need to coordinate the release of information when there is an emergency or a major impact on the business. There may be limited information about the incident or its potential impact. So, pag crisis communication or crisis researcher ka, you must be a futurist. Alam mo dapat yung possible na mangyayari. Kung maaaring negative or positive effect siya. Pero dapat din ma-reconcile mo sa isip mo kung negative pa siya, aling maaaring mong application about doon. Kung positive siya, try to think other positive ways para matugunan pa ang kailangan. Hi guys. So, here is the example of diagram about crisis communication plan. So, as you can see, on the top, decide on your overarching objectives. Ano ba yung objectives mo about sa pangyayari yun? So, mag-create tayo ng example. May isang politician, masira ka ng image. So, as a communication expert, ano yung gagawin natin to make his or her image na maganda? So, sino ba nag-trend ng politician ngayon?
Si
Obama. Yes, Ate Clarence.
Si Donald Trump. May kumpor pa. Si Donald Trump.
So, si Donald Trump. Ano ba yung isa sa kanya?
In refugee.
In Mexico.
Diba? Sinarado niya yung border ng Amerika sa mga borders. Sa mga refugees. So, malaking threat yun for other refugees na gustong lumikas.
Yes.
So, ano yung gagawin mo? Bakit ba niya naisip yun? Try to take an example para matugunan mo para lumilis yung image niya.
Explain his motives.
Maaaring siguro.
Explain his motives.
Yes, very right. So tama sa
Naka 30 pairs.
No. So, on the left side, ano sabi mo sa left side? Select the channels of communication. So as we are living in the fourth estate, madami ng medium na maaatay gamitin. Ano-ano yung mga yun? Give example. So from the right side, ano masasabi ba kayo? Ano example ng communication?
Social media.
Social media. Others.
TV show.
Radio.
Radio. Madaming kinds of communication, but we should not only focus for one. Kasi we should be broad. Ang tao, hindi lang hindi sa yan. Madami sila. So, mag-focus tayo dun kung saan sila naaabot. So, tayo, madami na nag-focus sa internet ngayon. So, dapat mas madaming vlogs or articles about dun. Or sa mga know our audience. Example, yung mga matatanda, ano ka rin yung inaanap kinds of communication? Di ba yung pagbabasa ng newspaper? Tama, pagbabasa ng balita. So, yung iba naman, paano yung mga blind? Ano form of communication? So, radio, yung maririnig. Di ba?
Blind.
So, next. On the right side, define your target audience. So, katulad na sinabi ko kanina, meron different kind of audience. Maaring bata, matanda, babae, lalaki. Oo, madaming klase. Dapat alamin mo kung sino sila at anong klase ng communication is yung pili mo sa kanan. Katulad ng sinabi na doon kanina, huwag ka magbigay ng information na iba. Kunyari, yung kausap mo is hindi pa ganun kaano sa English. So, are you telling them na mag-speaking sa English or to understand para makaintindi ng English? So, mali-mali yun. Abutin mo yung kakayahan nila. Sabi nga nila, abutin mo yung nasa daylayan.
Yes. Wow!
So, do not trust yourself or elevate yourself
from
there. Move on!
That's worse.
Next, choose your key messages. Ano ba yung key messages?
5-5.
So,
is there a delivery?
Ang crisis communication better siya. Hindi mo kailangan na. So, tingin sa akin, tingin sa speaker. So, choose your key message. Ang crisis communication ba, hindi siya direct siya. Hindi siya tulad ng feature writing. Napapabulak-laki mo pa yung salita para ma-explore pa ng audience. No, that is wrong. So kung ano yung gusto ng audience malaman, ay nakaagad yung ibigay mong information. Feed them with the right information. So next, so crisis researcher. So we have different kinds of researchers. In terms of crisis, katulad ng sinabi ko kanina, if there is typhoon, makakontakin mo the agency or the person who is related to the crisis. So, next. So, let us define first, what is researcher? So, Jenny, ikaw naman, what is researcher? So, tama. Sabi na. Okay. So, sabi yung pagkabasa ni Jenny. Ang researcher.
Bago tapos na, guys!
Ang researcher daw. There is academic or scientific research. Sabi ko nga, there is a lot of communication. Pwede yung academic course, ha? terms of science. So sabi din dito, a communication researcher is a communication, is a person whose job is to involve himself in discovering or verifying information for use in a book or program, etc. So, bilang isang researcher, dapat, katulad natin, nag-thesis tayo. Ano ba yung goal ng thesis natin?
Graduate!
So, tama, yan. Ang isang factor ay makagraduate. Pero, kung papalalimin mo, ang goal talaga ng research is to open a new book of knowledge. Yes. So, ayun ang goal natin na maibigay yung right message. So, next. So, what are the things that needs to include in our communication plan? So, there is a lot of things to be included in our plan. So, first, there should be a signed endorsement from senior leadership such as director and senior managers. So, dapat alam nung nasa hierarchy o nung nasa mataas sa posisyon yung ginagawa mo. You should have a communication between any members of the agency. So, next, there would be a designated responsibilities for public information teams. So, dapat may kanya-kanya trabaho ang bawat department na matutugon sa pangangailangan ng mga tao. Kung narin may kailangan sa communication, ibigay mo yung pangangailangan sa food, ano ba, shelter or anything. So next, internal information verification and expedited clearance procedures. So, internal information, between your agency you have communication. So, regional and local agreements and information release authority. So, you will define who, kung saan yung galing yung source. Okay? So, the next one, regional and local media, contact basically after us news desk. So, ito, common natin itong na makikita or nagagawa. Kasi, pag may mga crisis, kailangan na ng contacts from the other companies or other person or other countries na makakatulong para magkaroon ng help sa nangangailangan. So the next one, procedure to coordinated public health organization response team, including procedure for development at GIC. So like what I have said, so related yung just that. So next. So this one is to be reported by Mr. Diones.
So my for communication ato by wide word web. Ano mga steps or anong ways para mabigay yung information para to ang next, mga informations kung paano tayo sa center one ng mga informations sa kaling may crisis for crisis communication like websites, email, broadcast, fax, burner, and things. Again, next please.
We next now.
Thank you for my person gumawa ng mga. So more than that everything here, for crisis communication plan is a resource of information that the golden place for my son information. Ayan. Next.
Are you seeing that?
Next of that for us to wrap this piece. One, it provides basic information at the structure. To provide information, so alam naman natin yan. It should be designed to assist with the emergency decisions, update the plan,
regularly scheduling the reviews, don't just wait for a certain number of changes to get yung mga plans for the rapid visits. Working through decisions, building relationships and things, and so on. Next steps for success. Number one, obtain signs and endorsements from seniors who live leadership. So, so, obtaining science endorsement, the seniors in leadership such as directors or seniors managers must support the need for crisis planning classes or meet certain things knowing evaluating. Like, for example, the process has been, the process must be through. And next, the response planning is coordinated. And last, they have an important role in class ownership. And next, responsibilities for the media, public, social media, and partner and information schemes. So, decided who is in charge of release of information to the public. And next, dapat including the media and partners, and information scheme partners, and the public update on the process. And the individuals must be attend to discuss and it's important they meet others on their responsibilities and advance for designate responsibility. And three, and information, verification, and clearance of procedures. Yeah. So one core function of crisis communication is information clearance. So you need to be planned. Who absolutely must give you or receive some information for established agreements for the release of authorities, who release the what, when, and how. Yun yung mga needs para ma-agree for authorities yung mga what, when, and how, and by how. How all media contacts, including after power numbers and things. So next. Plan procedures to coordinate with the public health response. Yeah. So in crisis, no communication team can function in isolation. The communication functions should be part of the formal decision system or support system, but should be always be integrated into the larger crisis response team. And dapat kung mag-create ka ng plan or mga procedures for health response teams, you need to create this the following. Number one, include an organization chart in your plan so you can quickly find people who are key resources para mahanap mo agad yung sining mga tutulungan. And don't operate out of the EOC, you find out who is you. Ayan. Number seven, designate spokesperson for public health issue and third party validators. And number eight, have agreements and procedures to join the GIC then activated. Okay. The principles behind EOC is the one centralized location for decision qualities. Para ma-agreement and yung mga agreement and procedures ng EOC are number one, agree ahead of time on personal staffing order for the GIC and makes this part of your plan. Next, establish the role key communication personnel will have in the GIC. And next, now the amount of work must be accomplished outside and develop procedures to secure needed resources. For number nine, yung mga space and equipment na gagamitan for these resources, local or okay, so you need to be obtained agreements with other local or non-government organization for support. Identify needs and mechanic.
Next.
This is for functions for INFS 1925. This is the amount of functions. Number one, information gathering, information dissemination, operation support, and
license.
Line of that, during the first 24-48 hours, so yung certain server or staff then yung plan during an emergency situation. So be first, because it's out of necessity. Be right, serious, it's not just a be credible, and if you know the business, she doesn't be compromised in terms of then for the initial basis by that, because this phase of influence and subsequent development of the crisis, the initial phase, to be triggered by an organization's identification of an equality event as a potential crisis, or may be considered a poor that is expected to sustain very definite amount of time, so hours or working. This phase is marked with the processes of evaluating potential risks that are required to pass the DSM mode, actions to secure the necessary principles, needed to make that expected during emergency situation, yung values ng sir, mounted na siya. So, be first. So, we dapat yung information na ibibigay or kailangan ng media and yung government, kailangan na ibibigay mo yun right on time. Tapos yung be right. So, yung information na yun na ibibigay mo na mas maaga, kailangan tama siya. So, dapat sure ka. Sure ka na tama yung information na kuha mo. Or next time na may emergency situation ulit, ikaw na yung preferred source kung nung public at nung media. Next. So, these are critical tasks during the initial phase of the crisis. Verification, notification and coordination, assessment, initial media response, assignments, and resource allocation. So, first, tell the media and the public what you know. Quickly update the media and the public on the status of research, tasks, and investigations when an event arises. In a disaster situation, you have to provide people with the information you currently have and not to review and give them regular updates as you obtain additional information. So for example, may incoming na type of sa Philippine Area of Responsibility. Kailangan at re-update po yung public and yung media about doon sa type of na paparating. And ano ba yung maaaring mag-epekto nun or kung saan yung typhoon. So every information na makukuha ko din about sa typhoon, kailangan i-update mo sila. Next. Verification. Or the information about the possible crisis event, either from the media or from the other professionals, maybe an attention is granted. So, may possibility na yung mga information na ibigay ng media and ng ibang organizations pwedeng magkamali. So, kailangan yung information na makukuha mo, kailangan i-verify mo muna bago mo ibigay sa mga tao. So, these are the helpful questions para mag-verify my information. So, where did the information originate? After you verify the source of that information, after you verify the source of that information, you should verify if that source is credible. And kung ano naman yung source, saan ba galing yung information na yun? Is it from a formal channels of communication, letters from the government officials, or is it from informal channels of communication like a call from health offices, or is it an official or rumor, or you got it sa Facebook post or email na natanggal mo? The characterization of the event possible to other systems available to us. Is the information consistent with other sources that are available? So, para ma-share mo din, na tama yung information na kuha mo, kailangan i-verify mo din sa ibang sources pero para mas yung information. So, kung ma-verify mo na, para mas yung information, para mas yung ibang source, so sure ka na tama yung information na kuha mo. Notification and coordination. Once you have verified the event, notify managers in your organization immediately. The more quickly you notify the chain of command, the more rapidly you will be able to coordinate with partner organizations. This translates into more efficient responses and less difficulties. The communication plan should be designated on the people who are notified. So, notification. So, after you ma-verify yung information na kuha mo, kailangan i-notify mo yung mga higher positions sa organization na kinabibilangan mo. Then after mo mag-verify, i-notify sila. Sila yung nakipag-coordinate sa mga related organizations na kailangan mo. So, next one. Initial media response.
So guys, sa akin naman ano, initial media response is the media meeting on your board. Assembling the fact is priority for your teams. One best way to satisfy media or the public is the need for information to control under the law. So for example, there's a news or incident. You just need to control those information na lalabas kasi makaka-affect siya sa balance or order ng isang community. Kasi merong mag-overreact, tapos meron din naman ma-affect. Next. Ayan, do not give in pressure to confirm or release information before it is confirmed by the expert or emergency operation center. So, pag merong incidents na, i-confirm nyo muna kung totoo ba ito o hindi. Kasi minsan, may mga taong gumagawa na talaga ng news para makipag-usapan. Next. Take the lead if you have the lead. If other organization is right to the lead, defer to them, continue to coordinate and be as helpful as possible. So if there is a news and then there is a sideline story, you need to cooperate with the other parties to make a story more interesting and more generalized. First is initial media response. Is the media meeting on your door? Sending the facts is a priority for your team. One of the best ways to satisfy media, public's need for information to control the flow of information. So for example, you are an organization and there is an incident. You need to control the information and the data na lumalabas. For example, meron flash news about sa isang company and yung agency mo is responsible for that assignment. So you need to control all the details and information that you're going to tell the public kasi minsan crucial din ang pagkakaya over feeding information with your audience. Ayan, do not give in to pressure to confirm or release information. So you need to estimate or distinguish yourself. If you're not the expert or you're not really responsible for the incident or you're not really related to the situation or you're not an authority, in other words, you need to restrain yourself from putting yourself in that issue. take lead if you have the lead. If another organization is rightfully the lead, defer to them, continue to coordinate, and be as helpful as possible. So if your if your organization needs this assignment and there is another organization who works with that incident, you need to cooperate as long as you don't offend each other to make another side story. I have released information initially, but be honest that your organization is still gathering information. For example, and on television, if there is cases within the politics, or some politicians have cases, they have done corruption or slander, any cases, some of the reporters on television, inaamin nila na hindi pa kompleto yung detalye na nare-report nila, wherein they were stating that the case is still under investigation, or there are some loopholes that is being observed within the case. Suggested responses for media. First, for example, yung statement nila. We've just learned about the situation and are trying to get more complete information right now. All of our efforts are directed at bringing the situation under control. I am not going to speculate about the cause of the incident at this time. I am not the authority on this subject. Let me have the name of the authority which is responsible. Call your right back. So, second ito. We're preparing a statement on that now. Can I send it about 2 hours? That's it. Get your information out early. And it's important, particularly with regards to disaster, to give public some idea of kinds of plans and procedures of your organization, which is formulating to manage the crisis. For example, if there will be a typhoon, the first thing that the Philippine Coast Guard, with regards to the procedures, they were sending off signals or alerts to all fishermen's or those shipping lines or shipping industry that they must cancel flights or no walang barkong maglalayag in Tagalog. Ayan, evaluate required response. During the initial phase, do an initial evaluation of the situation to help you plan the level of public information and media response to your board. Okay, dun sa initial phase, you need to prepare some of the information that will be discussed to the public were enough for them to be able to know or to identify kung gaano kalakas or how big will be the impact of that disaster. Okay, the following questions to be considered. Ito, for example, if there will be another disaster, these are the questions na lagi tinatanong ng public sa media or sa government. Kung gaano kalaki, kung gaano kalakas, kung sino yung apektado, specific group of people na biktima talaga, kung gaano kalala yung apektado, kung gaano ka yung government. Yun na. Parang very self-explanatory. This is the first, worst, biggest, ito na ba yung pinakamalakas na nangyari. Ang ilan siya sa record ng type 1 na lalakasan na rin sa katawin yung apektuhan.
Good afternoon, so I'm the second to the last reporter from Group 3. So this is my report, applying the crisis tracking device throughout the response. So this topic includes 9 steps in applying the crisis throughout the response. But in my report, I will only report the step 1 to 5 and Cavin Larcena will report the step 6 to 9 and the conclusion. So the first step in applying the response is to verify the situation. So how do we verify the situation? So first, we need to get the facts and verify them with secondary sources. But the verification is only to the degree of possibility. If it's not possible, then you can only get the facts and not verify them. But as long as possible, we should verify the facts. So next step, so next is to find out where the information originated and determine credibility. So was the information credible or is the sources credible in getting those facts? So we need to check them if they are credible. Because maybe they are just some hoaxes or rumors, maybe they are not true. So yeah, we need to verify them. Tapos next, question possible rumors or hoaxes, which can be found through traditional and social media. So why do we need to question the rumors or hoaxes? Because rumors and hoaxes will not reach you if it's not particularly true. Because rumors and hoaxes sometimes have truth in them, right? So we should question them if they are true, if they are not. So we can clarify if that's just a hoax or rumors. So determine whether the information is consistent with other reports. So I will give you a scenario. This happened on the series that I'm watching before. The title of the series is Pinocchio. So they report that the cause of the death of the woman is because she was trying to get sexy to get his husband back. But the truth is, she does it for her children, for her child, because her child needs liver transplant, and she needs to get to lose weight to be able to donate her liver. But the first station broadcast that she just did it just to get her husband back. But the second station report that she did it for her child. So that's why we should determine if the information is consistent. So we can deliver a more accurate information. Okay, next. Determine whether the characterization of the event is plausible. Next. Clarify information and understanding through SME. So what is SME? SME is subject matter expert. So you should take note of that. Subject matter expert is SME. Clarify information and understanding through SME. Next, address the scope and the scale of events by answering questions such as how much, how many, and how big an area. So these scope and scale will papasok siya sa parang statistics of the event. So how much are the cost of destruction, maybe something like that. How many are injured or how many are dead? How big an area? So how big an area is now PC is mga ganun. So let's begin to identify staffing and resource needs for the expected media and public interest. Tapos consider ways to access additional information and decide who should be notified of this potential crisis. So in deciding who should be notified, so we should notify the involved persons here, such as agencies or interested groups. So next step is conduct notification. Okay, what's the first step?
Verify the situation.
Verify the situation. Next step is conduct notification. So in conducting notification, it is essential to carefully identify the following. So who should you include in your chain of command? Okay, example, you're an EIC of a publication. And there's an storm coming. So who should you include in your chain of command? Siyempre, yung researchers, mga editors, mga ganon. Ganon din sa government, parang ganon sa government. If there's a case, kunwari, mayor ka, so siyempre include mo rin kung sino yung mga organization na dapat mong i-notify pagka merong crisis. Okay, so up to what level? So this is really needed. So di ba, kunwari may mga fire alarms. Inaano nila are tular like tools. Diba yung nilevel nila ang classification para makapag-ready yung mga resident kung anong dapat nilang ikakanta. Kung dapat ba sila lumikas o hindi. Bye or dead. Where we need the scope of organization. So ito rin, dapat dapat din alam mo kung saan scope ng organization. Kunwari, yung bagyo, syempre di ba ang notify mo eh. Notify mo pag-asa, ganyan, world weather. Tapos pagka naman mga disaster, di ba? So, next is, so ito yung mga guidelines for notification yun. Ngayon nabanggit ko, yung pangatlo question. So, pag-lahat agencies, pero this is the general guidelines for USA. But they also, parang ano, inaano nila for general public. Kasi di ba, yung ibang nandito, meron din naman tayo. Kaya ito na rin yung inaano na guidelines. So local agencies, law enforcement, public health organization, emergency medical certificate services, hospital, fire departments, medical examiner, local department of homeland security. So this one is for US. Tapos local general service organization. Tapos state agencies, mga yun. Tapos federal agencies. Basta, so ano yung mga involved na organization, eh yun dapat may notify para alam nila yung mga gagawin nila. Okay, next. Step 3. Alam niyo step 1?
Verify the situation.
Step 2.
Conduct notification.
Tapos step 3.
Conduct crisis.
Conduct crisis assessment. Or we can call this the... we can call this the activate crisis plan. Yes. Conduct crisis assessment or activate crisis plan. Yun. So, dito, ano... Pwedeng, ito yung mga guidelines na, ito yung mga sample question guidelines na pwede mong para makapag-focus na ma-isagawa mo yung conduct crisis assessment. Okay, ito. What organization, office, or individual is in charge of managing the crisis? Okay. Ensure that the direct frequent contact with the office is in charge is possible. So, ganun din, parang sa step to round din, syempre dapat i-notify mo yung mga organization. Tapos, what happened and what response are occurring? Meron na ba, example, an earthquake happened, so meron na ba response? Meron na ba mga tumating ng tulong? Ganun. Tapos, what is your organization doing to address this crisis? Siyempre, dapat hindi lang yung parang kunan-kunan ako ang ginagawa ng mga organization na ganito. Siyempre, dapat mismo organization natin may ginagawa dun sa nangyaring crisis. So, what other agencies are collecting information and how is that being compiled? So, parang counter-checking lang din. Kung ano yung mga nakuha nila ng information, dapat makukuha mo rin yun para consistent yung information. Tapos, what are other agencies, organizations doing in their response? So, who is being affected by the crisis? What are their perceptions? What do they want to need to know? How they can be reached? Yun. So, di ba pagka may mga nangyayaring crisis, di ba? Interview din ng mga reporters, yung mga top involved. Siyempre, parang makukuha din yung site yung mga reactions nila. Kung ano yung nakaramdaman nila nangyayari yung crisis na yun. Tapos, ano, what should be the public doing? Siyempre, kaya mo itanong yun para malaman mo, kung para masabihin mo sila kung ano yung mga dapat lang gawin. Yun. Tapos, what is being reported on the web and the media? Active, formal, and informal monitoring system. Yun. Siyempre, dapat naglalagay din tayo ng information sa media kasi ito na yung pinaka-accessible ngayon, di ba? Tapos, what is being said in the about it, what is being said about the event? What is information? Is the information accurate, determined, and the consistency of information across sources? Tapos next step is organize assignments quickly. So yung organize assignments quickly, it can be divided into two parts: immediate issues and ongoing issues. So in immediate issues. You should determine who is managing the event from an operations, programming, and scientific perspective. Tapos dapat natin consider kung how communication coordinates with the program staff in charge of managing the crisis. What meetings should communication staff attend? So parang dito lang sa immediate issues, sinasabi na pagka mag-organize ka ng mga assignments, sa immediate issues, yung mga mismo nagaganap. Sino yung mga staff na gandun, kung ano yung nangyayari, ganyan. Tapos sa ongoing organizational issues, dito na yung pumasok na kala, yung Yolanda, di ba Yolanda? Ongoing organizational issues. Pwedeng i-ano dyan, talahayin dyan, yung kung meron na ba silang natuloy ngayon, yung after na kayo, di ba matagal na yung event, like, yung crisis na yun, pero inaalam pa rin kung meron pang mabago. Yun. Ulit, step one. Tapos number four, organize assignments weekly. So this will be my last topic. Step five, prepare information and obtain approval. So, bakit natin kailangan ng approvals? Kasi, hindi naman sa lahat ng pagkakataon, lahat ng ginagawa mong decision, tama. Siyempre dapat kumuha ka rin ng approvals from the higher-ups para malaman mo kung tama talaga yung ginagawa mo. So, recap, last na to. Step one, sana lahat pati ang sumagot ha. Step one.
Verify the situation.
Step two.
Handa ang notification.
Step three.
Handa.
Then,
Step 9, monitor events, monitoring should occur at all times. Ipagpalagay na meron kang palitan na days in 2 days. Magmo-monitor ka pa rin kasi meron pa din feedback, meron pa din yung event na yun is hindi naman nag-last for possible for 1 week. Kasi more or most, di ba 1 month, para sa, kung depende sa kung gano'n ka lang apektado. So, kailangan pa rin magkaroon ng monitoring. Then, conclusion, planning is important. Planning is important, especially to the first 24 to 48 hours, equivalent for 2 days. First, yung unang araw na nagkaroon ng event, ng disaster. Then, the following day, yung result nun. Then, yung needs ng mga tao na nag-visiting. Then, planning ahead of time. Siguro sa national disaster, meron na naman, di ba, yung mga ano, parang sa mga evaluation. Then, meron akong checklist ng mga notification. Dito malalaman if kung effective ba yung ginagawang activities nila, communication sila nila. Hindi ko alam ito kung before and after pa, pero yun. Anayin ko na lang, pag dito i-play na lang, kasi okay.